Hello and welcome to Startup Hack. Today we are going to talk about more JavaScript interview questions, so let's jump right in. Make sure to check out the link down below because we always provide the code samples that you can pull down and follow along so you can see in our project. Right, so the first question is, how does prototypal inheritance work in JavaScript? JavaScript uses prototypal inheritance where objects can inherit properties and methods from other objects through their prototypes. This mechanism allows for code reuse and the creation of object hierarchies. So as you can see in the example, we have two constructors, functions animal and dog. Animal serves as the parent object with a property name and a method sayName. Dog is the child object inheriting from animal. It has additional property breed and a method bark. We set up the inheritance relationship using object.create animal.prototype to set dog.prototype to a new object that inherits from animal.prototype. We also fix the constructor property on dog.prototype to point back to dog. By creating instances of animal and dog, we can see how methods are inherited and specific to each object. Do you want to earn $100,000 a year? Do you want to become a software developer within just 3 months? With our amazing course and awesome tutors, you never have to worry about getting stuck. We help students to learn skills that companies want to hire. We are Startup Hack. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. So let's get started. Okay, now, so the next question is, what is functional programming and what are the features of JavaScript that make it a candidate as a functional language? Functional programming is a programming paradigm that treats computation as the evolution of mathematical functions. JavaScript supports functional programming through features like first-class functions, higher-order functions, and support for anonymous functions. In the previous video, I had explained you about higher-order functions, so now I'm going to explain you anonymous functions. So here's an example. Immutable array is an example of creating an immutable array using object.freeze. Add is a pure function that always produces the same output for the same input. So as you can see in the example. The next question is, why functions are called first class objects? So in JavaScript, functions are considered first class objects because they can be assigned to variables, passed as arguments, and written from other functions. This flexibility is fundamental to functional programming. So in this example, the greet function is assigned to variable hello. So the apply operation function takes another function, add as an argument. The create multiplier function returns another function. Functions add, greet, double are stored in the function array. These examples demonstrate how functions in JavaScript can be treated as first-class objects, allowing for more flexible and expressive code. Okay, now the next question is, implement the array.prototype.filter method by hand. Array.prototype.filter creates a new array with elements that pass a test implemented by the provided function. Manually, you iterate through the array, apply the filtering condition, and build a new array with the filtered elements. So in this implementation, callback is the function to execute on each element in the array. This ARG is the optional context to use when executing the callback. The function iterates through each element of the array and applies the callback function to each element. If the callback returns true for an element, it adds that element to the filtered array. The filtered array is then returned. So here's an example. Alright, the next question is, what is ECMAScript? ECMAScript is the standard upon which JavaScript is based. It defines the features of the language, ensuring consistency among different implementations. JavaScript follows the ECMAScript standard to maintain interoperability across various platforms. So in this example, we have a function factorial that calculates the factorial of a given number n. The function checks if n is 0 or 1. In which case it returns 1 since the factorial of 0 and 1 is 1. Otherwise, it recursively calculates the factorial by multiplying n with the factorial of n minus 1. Finally, it prints the factorial of 5 using console.log. So here's an example. The last question is, what is the difference between while, let, and const keywords? The var keyword has function scope, let has block scope, and const has also
Block scope but is used for variables that should not be reassigned. Understanding the scope and mutability difference is crucial for writing robust JavaScript code. So first example is var. Var is a function scope. Variables declared with var are function scope, meaning they are accessible with the function in which they are declared. Variables declared with var can be redeclared and updated. Variables declared with var are hoisted to the top of their scope, meaning they are processed before the code runs. So the next example is the let. Let is blocked scope. Variables declared with let are only accessible within the block in which they are declared. Block is usually defined by curly braces. So variables declared with let can be updated but not redeclared within the same block scope. Variables declared with let are not hoisted to the top of their scope. The last is const. So const is also block scope. Variables declared with const cannot be reassigned once they are initialized. However, if the variable is an object or array, the properties or elements of that object or array can be modified. Variables declared with const are not hoisted to the top of their scope. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned these JavaScript interview questions. So don't forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon for latest updates.
To joining our course, you can simply go to our website called startuphack.com. Thank you.